Não tem mais. Nesse período, sempre me chamam e tentam falar mais sobre a população. I chose the mathematics figure 21 to try A. The figure is shown on screen and is the opposite basis for how we connect the source and the variable system for the purpose of our models using the Multisim.
So now let's start to connect the voltage. So now we call the electric flow of the capacitor in amps based on the given circuit. So first, let's try to find the voltage source of the voltage source of the circuit of the copper that next, let's locate the resistor. And the resistor is located beside the voltage source. So for the capacitor, since the given value is already in ohms, so let's use the resistor as the replacement for the capacitor. Now, for the ammeter, since we have to find the current, we use the ammeter. And for the ammeter, we can use digital ammeter, which is the paper. So, click in the paper, then click the ammeter, and you can choose whether the ammeter is horizontal or vertical. But in this video, I will be using a motor possible, which is to paper the top right. So here is a motor paper and it's good. Yeah, this one didn't quicker. You need to call the tube, not the motor. Not the motor is. Now, before we move on, let's try to add a nice part. Now after we run it, there is a value shown for all of them. So the alternative 1 is 3 amperes, but the alternative 2 is 1.5 amperes. And same goes for the alternative 3 is 1.5 amperes. This 1.5 amperes is the current across the R1 and R2. And then let's rotate this value. So based on the values written in motor capacitor, the current across the resistor is in 1.5 amperes. And same goes for the measured current across the capacitor, which is like in 1.5 amperes. Then measuring the values in our experiment, we use the volume theorem. Square root of IR squared plus IT squared. Square root of 1.5 squared plus 1.5 squared equals to 2.4.